Hello and welcome to Sports Gaming Universe channel here on YouTube, and welcome back to Junk Gaming Video Zone Mac Daddy Road to the Show series here in MLB 15 The Show on the PS4. Now some of you were asking for some Mac Daddy action in the comments of the last couple videos that we put out Road to the Show wise, so here you go. Junk played it for you, and I'm bringing you the commentary. Mac Daddy hitting that one down the left field line and getting himself a double, kept it fair, and gets on base against the Indians here. Cleveland up 3-0 in the seventh inning, however, when he's up again, and that's going to get past the shortstop. Well, he knocks it down anyway and keeps it in the infield, but it's an infield single. 5-1 now in the ninth. Twins got to figure something out here. That ball is crushed to left field. Does it have enough to get out of here? It's over the fence, over the high wall. Mac Daddy hits the Daddy Dinger, and it is gone. Helping him get a little closer here in the ninth inning. Just a solo shot. It was a line drive style as well, so didn't know if it would get up over the high wall and left there, but it certainly does. Has enough carry to get on out of here, and it got out quickly. Let's watch it here. Fly on out, and it just does clear the fence by a couple rows. Mac Daddy very much the bright spot in a Twins loss right here, 5-2. He has three hits. But Jordan Lyles outdoes the Twins here, goes 6 2/3, and picks up a victory and player of the game honors. So Cleveland taking that one 5-2. Milestone here, first major league three hit, three at bat game. First game, 3-for-3, really? Huh, interesting. I think what Junk was trying to show us there is that Miguel Sano on the shelf 1 to 2 months, not good at all for the Twins. This one hit well, opposite field. And, oh, off the top of the wall, just under the yellow line there, signifying home run, but it's underneath it there. And is this a replay? Nope, because he hit this one further, and it's definitely over the yellow line and gone. Home run, Mac Daddy, another Daddy Dinger, another opposite field shot this time. He said, you know, I came really close on the first swing. Second one, I'm not going to miss, and he deposits it in the seat. Second home run of the series. Nice swing opposite field there, and he knows it's gone. He has the satisfaction of watching this thing fly out. Doesn't have to run in doubt here. He just watches it go. So it's 2-0 Twins in the fifth inning. One out. He's up again, and he's going opposite field again, and this time he's hitting the gap, and he should be able to get to second base with no problem there. He's got himself a double. All right, he's definitely swinging a hot bat today. Now it's still 2-0 Twins, bottom of the sixth. This looks like a double play opportunity, and that's exactly what they'll end up with. Turning two right there and thwarting the Indians' chances. Top of the seventh now. He again hits a rocket shot opposite field. This one's going to be tracked down by the left fielder, however. Solid out there. 3-0 Twins, top of the eighth. Runners at the corners with two outs. And an excuse me swing is going to get him on base with the infield single. Give him an RBI. Nice job right there. Next man up is Boris Byers. And what a name. And he goes deep, the three-run shot. Twins up 8-0 in the ninth. And they finally get Mac Daddy swinging there. Now, they've gotten him out before, but that's the first time he didn't make contact. 4-for-6 in the game. Goes deep again. He's not your player of the game, though. That goes to Jose Berrios, who goes the distance and gets the win for the Twins. I've said it before. I'd love to see that guy come up to the majors and contribute in real life. Have to wait for that, though. So Mac Daddy powers up a little bit, and we're powering on to Chicago. Taking an awesome 17-5 record into today's ball game. That ball's hit well to center field, and it's going to be caught by the center fielder. He ranges back and makes the play. No score in the bottom of the second. This is going to be bounced to second base. Should be a routine play. Throws on over to Mac Daddy, and they get the out. Let's go to the fourth inning. 2-0 White Sox, and that is going to be hit well to right field, and he's not going to have a play on it. Hits off the base of the fence. And he's going to hustle the second base. So another double for Mac Daddy. And he continues to hit the ball well to the opposite field. Mac Daddy's now going to score on that ball up the middle. Knocked down. Kept in the infield, but it doesn't matter. Infield single and the run will score. They cut the lead in half. It's now 2-1. Again, an opposite field hit. This one is going to find its way into the right center field gap. getting to the fence. He's got two, but he's thinking about three. The relay throw is not in time. Think he got there. Anyway, it's 3-2 now, and he's got another at bat. That one right up the middle. Sharp base hit. Should score two runs, and the Twins have now taken the lead. Mac Daddy producing yet again today. Swinging a great bat. Two more RBI right there. They're up 6-3 in the ninth. What's he going to do for an encore? Well, he goes opposite field again and deep, but it is caught. So they will get him out here. Man, he's putting good swings on the baseball in this episode, though. He's your player of the game here, leading his team with three RBI and going 3-for-5. So he takes down the White Sox. They're now 18-5 on the season. The White Sox now a below 500 ball club with that loss yesterday. Let's see how it goes today. Oh, just a random ground out. It's kind of disappointing the way Mac Daddy's been hitting the baseball to see him actually ground out there, but okay. 0-2 count now in his next at bat. He's not grounding out there. It's hit well the right center field. They're not going to catch that either. One hop off the fence, or it may have just hit the base of the fence on the fly. Either way, it's a double, and he's driven home another run. Wow, Mac Daddy is red hot now. He stands on second base, and, well, don't stand on second base any longer. He's going to try to score. Oh, did they put the stop sign on him? Yeah, and for good reason, he's thrown out at the plate. It's now a 2-2 game in the fourth inning, and that's a bunt, and they're going to have their man at first base. Trying to get on one way or another. Well, it does not work. So here is a ground ball to second base. Another routine play. Mac Daddy steps on first, fields that throw, and he's out. Okay, we go to the top of the sixth inning. Tied 2-2 still. And he's going to hit that right up the middle for a base hit. Solid single to center field. Well, it's not an extra base hit that time around, but it does get him on base. And oh, they got him picked off, except you know what this means. He's safe because of that glitch where the first baseman never throws a hard throw at a second base. Again, I'll say it. It needs to be fixed next year in MLB 16. Here he's going to tag up on a deep fly ball to center field. Should have no problem scoring. They'll just get that on in and not even have a throw to the plate. So he scores on the sacrifice fly. Twins take the lead 3-2. How about an eighth inning at bat? Just going to roll that down to first base. And he will be out. Easy play right there for Abreu. So we get this tied up. The White Sox come back. And we end up in extra innings. Kind of in a check swing there. It didn't really mean to swing, and he hits into a double play. Tough one right there. The White Sox win it in extras, and they get themselves back to 500 at 12-12. Jose Abreu, your player of the game. Twins couldn't quite get it done there, but that's okay. They've been playing some amazing baseball to start this season. 19-6. Can they get to 20 wins today? Well, let's find out. First inning, Mac Daddy hitting right-handed, and whoa, okay. Might have had a play there at first base, but definitely didn't make a play fielding first. Kind of Olay'd that thing, but it's okay. White Sox get out of the inning. They're up 1-0 right now. That was a chase by Mac Daddy right there. Yeah, you see everything. Oh, I love that little glitch there where they have that swing animation after they've been standing there. Silly. Anyway, that's a much better swing, and it is to left center field. It is going to be caught, though. Caught right about at the warning track. Mac Daddy is out. 4-3 Chicago. Seventh inning, but two runners on. Big spot, and he hits it well. Left center field. And he can't come up with it. It's going to be over his head and off the fence. Runners kind of delayed there. Going to the plate. He will be safe. Second and third now. Mac Daddy's double does bring home a run. They're up 5-4 when he comes up in the eighth inning, and they're going to walk him because they got first base open. No sense in pitching to him right now. Set up your forces and not take your beating off the bat of Mac Daddy. So he's going to walk right there. They're going to push home some runs and win this thing 7-4. So they come back and get their 20th win of the season. Salvador Perez, your player of the game, had himself a nice day. And now a Twin, I guess, Salvador Perez. That's cool. So that's going to wrap up the episode for Mac Daddy. The Twins shot out of a cannon to start this thing at 20-6. Come on back for more Road to the Show. We'll see you then.
Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed the video, go ahead and join the SGU team. Subscribe right here on YouTube to get daily videos from SGU, as well as frequent live streaming events. Give us a follow on Twitter for up-to-the-minute information on channel uploads. And last but not least, check out the SGU Facebook page. So what are you waiting for? Join in on the fun today!